Hey there, thanks for continuing to watch this series on creating a REST API with Mendix. In this video, we're going to create a delete method for the vehicle collection API because I only have so much space in my garage for all these vehicles. For this delete method, we want the user to supply the ID of the vehicle in the request URL, have a microflow find the vehicle, and then delete it from the database. Let's head back to the desktop modeler and open up the vehicle messages definition. I'm going to create a new definition called delete and choose the vehicle entity. In the property list, I check mark on the vehicle ID because that's the only value I care about when I look up a vehicle to delete it. Now I'll go ahead and create the delete vehicle microflow. In this microflow, I'll add an integer parameter representing the vehicle ID I want to delete. In the flow, I'll add a retrieve activity and set it to look up the ID in the database. To do that, I'm going to change the range of the retrieve to be the first record because there should be only one that gets returned from the database. The reason only one is returned is I'm adding some XPath to filter the results to where the vehicle ID matches the parameter value. The resulting output will be a vehicle object. To be certain there is a record to delete, I need to check to see if the vehicle object supplied by the retrieve has any data in it. To do that, I add an exclusive split to the microflow. An exclusive split is basically an if statement or a decision point. In the definition of the split, I add a caption to identify what it's doing. For the expression, I write an if statement that looks at the vehicle object and returns a Boolean based on whether it's empty or not. From the split, I'll drag a line down from the conditional and add a log activity. Double-clicking the line in between allows me to select the value from the split I want this path to represent. I'll choose true. In the log activity, I'll give it a node name and add some text saying no vehicle has been found. Then I'll add an end event afterwards with no return value. On the false path, I'm going to add an export with mapping activity so I can capture the record being deleted. I'll use the vehicle export mapping and choose the vehicle object from the dropdown. The content is JSON again, so we want to make sure that the radio button is selected. And for output, I want to put the result into a string variable I'll call my vehicle. I'm going to add another log message after the export to capture the my vehicle string. We'll name this log entry falsy and add the MyVehicle string to the parameters list, referencing it in the template area. Saving the most important for almost last, add a delete object after the log message and choose the vehicle object from the dropdown. Because I believe in return values, I'm going to have the method return the MyVehicle string if false, and if true, a simple statement matching what I've put in the log. Let's add this method to the API, which will bring us right to the properties panel for the new method inside the API definition. I'll choose delete, and you'll notice that the definition has added vehicle ID to delete parameter we created in the microflow as a query string parameter in the URI. While typing in vehicle ID to delete each time I use this API is a pain, so let's just make inputting the vehicle ID part of the path for the method. Save and fire up the API again. In the Swagger definition, you see the delete method has been added. I'll do a get first to get a list of vehicles. Unfortunately, it's time for Mr. Mercedes to leave the barn for good. It has a vehicle ID of 1. Click on the delete method to try it out. In the input for the vehicle ID, place 1 and then click execute. We get a 200 response, which is good. If we head back over to the desktop modeler, we can see in the log that the log node falsy ran, so that means the vehicle ID was found and removed from the database. Bye bye, Mercedes!